Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashish Banerjee. I am going to give you a very brief introduction to the holistic approach to hospital administration. So many books have been written on hospital administration, but they often lack the wealth of experience that can only be described by a senior administrator who has been through it all. To mention just a few examples, the turf wars between super specialists in a tertiary care hospital is not touched upon in any lecture or book or even in a Google search. The endeavor of this presentation is to give the listeners a feel of the problems and solutions which are encountered in a real tertiary care hospital. Some lesser-known facts about tertiary care hospitals are as follows. The main revenue earners in a tertiary care hospital are not people on the payroll. In fact, they are usually consultants who work on a fee-for-service system, which creates a huge number of problems for the administration. For example, they come at their own sweet time. They are very unpunctual. They may not attend important meetings. And there's a lot of intense competition between them, which makes it difficult for the hospital administrator to manage the whole situation. The backbone of all hospitals are the RMOs, and they are among the most nomadic group of employees in the whole of the world. They are literally here today, gone tomorrow. They may not resign. They may not even say goodbye. They don't leave a resignation letter at times. Nurses are slightly better. They follow some protocols. But there's a huge nurse attrition problem in India, and most hospitals have to use the services of BMS, BHMS doctors in the wards, which is strictly not allowed. It's a gray area, but they are being utilized all over the place. The practice is very rampant. Support services in a hospital are extremely important, and patients expect five-star comfort in a hospital, and this may often be a cause of concern to an administrator. Patient dissatisfaction is a huge problem. Quality at every step and in every process is a huge challenge, and people are not very happy to cooperate about giving quality. Human resources becomes very difficult. There's a lot of drain on materials and finance, but this has to be achieved. A good administrator needs to have excellent domain knowledge, as it's called, about the hospital, familiarity with a plethora of medical terms, and must constantly update her knowledge to keep pace with a rapidly changing world of technology. Knowledge of finance is very important, especially what is called profit and loss, or just known as P&L. And the motivation to work hard and tackle a 24/7 week is a must. I hope these words have not scared you. They should rather inspire you to become an excellent hospital administrator. Many of you are already working in hospitals in different positions, but may want to get to more senior administrative positions and may become a CEO or a COO. Don't think it's beyond your scope. In that case, this course is for you. We will endeavor to discuss the items and issues mentioned above and also try to answer all your queries through the platform provided by Medical Learning Hub. So I therefore invite you to join me in this journey. Thank you very much.